In the wake of the arcade party of the Guitar Hero franchise and the all-in-one ambitions of Rock Band, Rocksmith burst onto the scene in 2011 with a single goal: to teach you how to play guitar or hone your skills by hooking up your real-life acts to its innovative tech. It wasn't perfect, but the potential was there for something great. Rocksmith 2014 aims to be that evolution. Not a sequel, but a genuine refinement of every aspect of the original release, while boasting a revamped setlist and leaps in user interactivity. That's exactly what it does. It's a challenge to review Rocksmith 2014 as purely a gaming experience, as it's more on the side of an interactive learning tool with a gaming sheen. For an amateur guitar player like myself, Rocksmith 2014 jumps out at the right places. It immediately familiarizes you with the game mechanics even if you haven't played the original version, setting you up for an appropriate playing style and sets you on an easy path to get underway. This is a welcome substitute rather than trudging through the world tour mode from the 2011 game that limited your freedom by locking progress until you went through it. Additionally, multiplayer is supported for simultaneous jamming with the guitar and bass, but you get the most out of Rocksmith 2014 as a singular experience. The new, extraordinarily streamlined interface makes navigating between modes effortless. The countless sections of lessons come stock with plenty of videos that accurately display how to do certain techniques or to play a particular chord, for example. You can freely flip between rhythm, lead, and bass guitar as you choose, and each come with their own missions to complete that unlock new skins for your gear and inlays for your virtual fretboard. Customization comes full circle in the Tone Designer, giving you a plenitude of sounds, loops, amps, and a ton of extra options to shape your guitar sound to play in any mode. You can create up to 3 sound rigs and assign them to the right stick to flip between. It's versatile, spontaneous, and it's awesome. Equally innovative and something that Rocksmith 2014 should lay proud claim to is its
session mode,
a practice area that lets you cut loose on the fretboard with the thumping drive of a computer-controlled band. You're given the option to choose instruments with different sounds, or if you're not too sure how to mix and match, you can load from a number of presets. Once you set your tempo, root note, and sound venue, you're free to play with the band adjusting to how loud and fast you play. Any prospective guitar player looking to learn their scales back to front will revel in the full fretboard display, giving you a handsome guideline to develop your timing no matter if you're a seasoned player or a first-time rocker. Others have mentioned that it's a shame that there's no recording function of any kind, and I have to say I am inclined to agree, but it's not intended to be a portable studio. The 50 songs on Rocksmith 2014's setlist are a healthy mix between rock and metal. It's a reasonably esoteric collection that may not be familiar to some players, but they're chosen to demonstrate different styles of guitar playing and offer a terrific slice of learning to adapt yourself to different genres. There can be quite a bit of latency even after calibrating that's extremely evident when you play the sound through a TV, but I encountered no issues whatsoever when I played it through my headphones and a hi-fi system. Despite this though, it does make you roll your eyes when the game informs you that you've repeatedly missed notes of songs that you already know how to play for real. If you're craving more options, you can import the entire setlist from the original game for a $10 licensing fee. It may seem like a cheeky move, but it doubles the amount of songs you can play, and it doesn't render your initial purchase completely useless. Fortunately, there's very little risk of not enjoying what's available thanks to the game engine adjusting to how well you play. The well-integrated riff repeater is given a stellar treatment this time around, as you can activate it while in the middle of a song with a single button press to master any section or the entire song as you choose. Tweaking the speed and difficulty affords enormous latitude in how you tackle your experience with Rocksmith 2014, as you can learn the song on your own terms the way you would in private study. Better yet, if you're doing really well, the game automatically defaults you to master mode, doing away with the fretboard cues if you can play the song perfectly note for note. It's the ultimate reward you're striving for in Rocksmith 2014, and the feeling it gives you that you've achieved something is much more palpable than many other games are capable of being able to do. If you're chasing a game score, Rocksmith 2014 includes a collection of guitar-based mini-games that act as clever learning exercises for chords, scales, and various guitar techniques with the Guitarcade. They're all designed with the aim to improve your dexterity and knowledge of the fretboard, but they're a small bit of fun that break up the pace of the game's signature formula. Scale Warriors is the standout for wannabe shredders looking to hone their speed more fluently, and the amusing take on zombies with the Return to Castle Chore Dead and the fast-paced Scale Racer are also great options. Rocksmith 2014 is a major step up from the original game and a textbook example of how you build on what you've already got and in the right way. Everything that's here is ideal for anyone wanting to grab a guitar and brush up on their skills or dive into the guitar world anew. From its marvellous session mode and wealth of side options that give you tremendous freedom, Rocksmith 2014 can happily continue to boast its marketing slogan. This really is the fastest way to learn guitar, but it's also arguably one of the best.